Hi there, this is Paula from Replicon. Approving items is a crucial step in the flow of data from timesheets, expense sheets, and time off bookings to business critical operations such as payroll and invoicing. Approvals help ensure that data is correct and won't cause downstream complications and losses for your organization. In this video, I'm going to give you an overview of how to set up approvals by walking you through the three main steps involved: setting up approval paths, configuring permissions and notifications, and assigning approval-related settings to users. At the same time, I hope to give you a sense of the flexibility Replicon offers in how approvals can be set up. Throughout this video, I'll mainly use timesheet approvals as an example, but note that the process is basically the same when setting up time off or expense approvals. An approval path specifies who approves items and in what sequence. In other words, they determine who approves an item first, second, third, etc. Approval paths are assigned to users in their user profiles, so ideally you'd set paths up before you add users, so they're available to assign to users. You can create as many paths as you need. To set up an approval path, go to the Approval Paths page for the type of item in question. So I'll just click Timesheet Approval Paths to demonstrate. Then I'll add a new path, or you can always use one of the defaults we provide if one of those works for you. Next, I'll give the new path a name. Now I'll specify the approval sequence by clicking the plus icon and adding approvers. Now if I only need one approver to approve items, I can simply add one approver. But if I need more than one user to approve items, I can assign multiple approvers to the path. In that case, I can choose whether the approvers receive each item simultaneously by adding them to the same step, or I can choose to have them approve items sequentially by adding them to different steps. In the second case, the first approver has to finish approving an item before it is sent to the next approver. When you're adding approvers to each step, there are some different ways to identify the approver. First, you can assign approvals by role. In this case, the approver is determined by their relationship to a user. For example, you can assign the supervisor role to a path, and the employee's supervisor will approve their items. This is a popular option since it's flexible, easy to assign to a large number of users, and may never have to be updated as staff change. Note that if you assign project manager or client representative to an approval path, they'll only be sent data related to projects they manage for approval. Refer to our video and help topic on setting up client approvers for more detailed information on that role. Or you could assign approvers by their name, choosing from a list of supervisors in your system. Our customers don't use this option very often since it makes reconfiguring more difficult if the approver needs to change. But it can be useful if, say, you have one administrator in your office who approves all items but isn't related to employees by a role. That is, they're not their supervisor or manager. Finally, you can assign a conditional approval rule to a path, rather than a role or named individual. With these rules, who approves depends on a condition defined in the rule. For example, we offer a rule that requires supervisors to approve only timesheets that include overtime. All timesheets without overtime are automatically approved by the system. Another time-triggered rule gives an approver a time limit for approving. If they miss the deadline, the timesheet is sent to their supervisor for approval. We offer a few out-of-the-box rules, like the two I just mentioned, that cover common scenarios for timesheets, time off, and expense approvals. But we can also easily create custom rules that cover just about any kind of approval scenario you can imagine. Contact our support team if you'd like more information on custom rules. Now that I've created an approval path, before I move on to assigning it to users, I'm going to make it my default path, the one that is automatically assigned to any new user added to the system. Make a path the default if it will be the most commonly used path of its type, in this case, timesheet paths. This will save you a step when setting up users and will reduce the risk of assigning the wrong path in error. Approvers need certain permissions before they can approve items. Approval permissions are enabled by default in the Supervisor and Project Manager permission profiles, but you might want to confirm these profiles are set up appropriately. While you're checking permissions, you'll also want to ensure approval-related notifications are enabled, so you can assign those to users too. There are notifications that alert approvers when items are ready for approval, and ones that let end users know when their items have been approved or rejected. The final step in setting up approvals is to assign the approval paths you created to employees in their user profiles. They need to be assigned a path for each type of item they use in Replicon. For example, if this user, Sam Spade, uses timesheets, expense sheets, and books time off in Replicon, I'll need to assign him a timesheet approval path, an expense approval path, and a time off approval path. To assign a timesheet approval path, click the Timesheets tab in his user profile and select the approval path from the dropdown. If it's the default path, it should be selected automatically, and you can skip this step. I can then assign a time off path from the time off tab, and an expense path on the expenses tab if needed. Next, I should check on the notifications tab that he has timesheet and time off notifications enabled, so he'll receive the messages I configured earlier when his items are approved. Finally, I might want to move to his approver's user profiles and confirm that they're assigned the correct permission sets and notifications. And that's about it for setting up approvals. Now, when Sam Spade submits a timesheet, time off booking, or expense sheet, it will be sent to the approver specified in the applicable approval path. If you need more help with this topic, or need more information on client approvals or conditional approval rules, go to www.replicon.com/help. If you'd like more information about custom approvals, please contact our support team. That's all from me for now. Thanks for your time.